distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen. As I reflected over what my message should be this evening, the Lord led me to a scripture that he had led me to in the past, especially about a year ago. As I reflected over some of the difficulties that our nation was going through, permit me to read from that scripture. It is in Exodus 14, verse 10 to 15. And I'll read Exodus 14, verse 10 to 15. It is the story of the children of Israel as they left captivity in Egypt, and they sought to go to the promised land. And when Pharaoh drew near, the children of Israel lifted their eyes, and behold, the Egyptians marched after them. So they were very afraid, and the children of Israel cried out to the Lord. Then they said to Moses, "Because there were no graves in Egypt, have you taken us away to die in the wilderness? Why have you dealt with us to bring us up out of Egypt?" Verse 12, "Is this not the word that we told you in Egypt, saying, 'Let us alone, that we may serve the Egyptians'? For it would have been better for us to serve the Egyptians than that we should die in the wilderness." And Moses said to the people, "Do not be afraid. Stand still and see the salvation of the Lord, which he will accomplish for you today. For the Egyptians whom you see today, you shall see again no more forever. The Lord will fight for you, and you shall hold your peace." And the Lord said to Moses, "Why do you cry to me? Tell the children of Israel to go forward." The children of Israel were on a journey of nation building. The Lord had promised to take them to a land flowing with milk and honey. They had just left the captivity of Egypt, where they were punished and cheated by Pharaoh and the Egyptians. God took them on a journey out of captivity, out of anguish, and promised them a place of comfort, abundance, and peace. But the journey was tougher than they expected. It was much harder than they expected. The conditions were much more hostile than they expected. And suddenly they saw Pharaoh and his army coming after them. They were unarmed, and one of the most vicious armies in history was coming after them. They ran in great fear with their wives and children. They carried the elderly, the disabled, and the babies. But in front of them was the Red Sea. No boats to cross the sea. They were between the proverbial devil and the deep blue sea. So they turned to their leader, Moses, who himself was now full of fear because he didn't expect what they were now experiencing. And there's a lesson here that when God puts you on a journey to your destiny, whether you are a person or a nation, it doesn't tell you what the challenges will be, lest you refuse to undertake the journey. So the Israelites turned to their leader Moses, saying, and this is in Exodus 14, verse 11. They said, "Is it because there were no graves in Egypt that you have taken us away to die in the wilderness? Why have you dealt with us to bring us up out of Egypt? Is this not the word that you were told in Egypt, where you said, 'Let us alone'? And we told you then, 'Leave us alone. Let us serve the Egyptians. Let us remain in captivity. For it would have been better for us to serve the Egyptians than that we should die in the wilderness.'" So it is in the journey of nation building and development. Our nation is no different. We are on a journey from the past. There have been times when the journey is somewhat tough, difficult, and even fearful. We look behind us and we see the armies of the past, the armies of division which led to a civil war where millions died, the armies of religious strife that refused to leave us, the armies of corruption and graft, those who want us to remain in the captivity of ethnic and religious conflict. We see the armies of the past. But ahead of us, we also see the Red Sea, bloody conflict, and the doomsayers who say that the future will be worse than the past. And then the people say, why did you take us from where we were? The same people who cried in anguish to the Lord now say, you should have left us in the past. You should have left us in Egypt. We didn't know that you were taking us out of captivity to kill us in the wilderness. And like Moses, the leadership said to God, what shall we do, O Lord? We didn't expect that this would be a journey to destruction. Then God said to Moses, and God speaks also to that journey. He said to Moses, why do you cry to me? Tell the children of Israel, tell the children of Nigeria to go forward. Go forward. Don't turn back. Moses, inspired by God, said to the children of Israel, go forward. He also said, do not be afraid. Stand still and see the salvation of the Lord, which he will accomplish for you today. For the Egyptians whom you see today, you shall see again no more forever. The Lord will fight for you, and you shall hold your peace. So I say to you, brethren in Christ, and fellow countrymen and women, let us go forward. Do not look back. The armies of the enemy that you see today, threatening to kill and maim, and the claws of poverty and injustice, you shall see no more forever. The Lord will fight for us, and we shall hold our peace. We must go forward. We are a people of prophecy. God has said concerning this nation that he's building a new nation, a nation where men and women of all tribes and faiths will dwell in love and peace, a nation where our young people will have ample opportunities for productive and rewarding work. The promises of God are sure and certain. 2 Corinthians 1 verse 20 tells us, for all the promises of God in him, in Christ, are yea and in him, amen, to the glory of God through us. All of God's promises are yes, they are amen, in Jesus Christ, but through us, through you and I. This is the future that we're heading for. And we're already going steadily and surely in that direction. God bless you all. God bless Nigeria.